strikeouts. He was dominant in his 1-2-3 fourth inning. Sear, the fourth pitcher of the game for Sacramento. Fastball at 96 in there for a strike on Orozco. And it's nothing on Orozco. Doubled and scored and walked. Switch hitter batting from the left side. Again, the Rivercats, they may use six or seven pitchers in this game this afternoon. And Sear to the plate, and the 0-1 is bounced back to Sear. He loves on the one up. Jogs several steps underhand to first. And there are two away in the fifth.
Nice play right there. Ball hit out away from you. Throw the away, ball away, and it's going to come right back at you. Sure enough, fielding position. Nice little play.
Yeah, that includes Benjamin McLean. Jason Hostler.
One hop. He's doing pretty well by Orozco, too. Good reaction by the 26-year-old right-hander from Fremont.
Yeah, one of the biggest thing pitching coaches always say, if you're going to throw away to a hitter, most of the time you're going to hit that ball right up the middle, so you have to be in good fielding position. Some pitchers can do it, some can't. As long as you got in front of the ball and you can snag it, we got that glove in front of you. I mean, some of those balls come right back at you over 100 miles an hour. It's a glimpse sometimes, and you just get out there and stab it if you can.
That's exactly what he did there. Here's Vossler. Vossler has walked and struck out 0-for-1. And Sear. Changed and missed on the slider, one ball and one strike.
You know, Tyler Beattie had one line drive coming right back and being caught by his left ear with a line drive, and that ball was smoked over 100 miles an hour. Some of those, you know, you just don't have a glimpse. I mean, they cut, you throw it and it comes back at you. You just catch it out of the corner of your eye, and hopefully you knock it down so it doesn't hurt your face or any body part. A lot of times you can hit the knees, the ankles, shins.